Hello and welcome to this session. This session is extension of our previous one where we have seen connecting 16x2 LCD with Arduino. So here we will add a push button and make a simple counter. So when we push a button, the counter on the number on LCD screen will increase. So for that we have taken our push button, which we already learned how it works. We have connected to a 100 ohm resistor just to avoid any short circuit, and also we don't want to keep pin number 7, which is configured as input, as floating. Okay, so let's start. So connection is very minimal, we have already connected it, so let's get directly into programming. So I have my live video feed here, you can see, and I have my Arduino editor. So in the live feed you can see I have already connected, so let me full screen. Yes, you can see I have already connected the push button, which is connected through this white wire to pin number 7, and there is a resistor connected to ground. I have used ground from this cathode through this 100 ohm resistor. Fine, so let's get back into programming. Okay, let's keep both the windows side by side and let's begin. So as you already know, we in our LCD chapter we have seen we have to include a library file known as liquid crystal. Okay, so and we also initiated the liquid crystal variable. We created an instance, in fact, of type liquid crystal, and pin number 13 is our register select, and pin number 12 is connected to enable, and 11, 10, 9 and 8 are connected to digital input, D4, D5, D6 and D7 of LCD. So this is the one time job. And now coming to our setup program, so we have to do lcd.begin and we want to configure at 16x2. That's it. 16,2. So what else we want to set up? We want to set up pin number 7, pin mode, pin number 7 as input. And let's give pin number 7 as some name instead of, let's say, push button, P button. And let's define P button here, int P button equals to 7. Fine. And okay, so that's all about the setup. So coming to loop, so as you know our program is, so let me remove these comments. You already know that setup and void both are important, setup and loop both are important, and setup runs only once and loop is a forever loop. It runs whatever inside throughout the life cycle of microcontroller, in fact power cycle of the microcontroller. Life cycle is too much. Void loop, coming to here, so what we want a push button. So suppose I want to push this button, and when I push there should be a counter here which should say 1, 2 or whatever like that. So for that, just think what you need. So what I feel is we have to first check whether the button is pressed or not. So how do we proceed? So we have to start with a simple if statement. If digital read P button which is our pin number 7, equals to high. And let me put this into brackets. And when this happens, what to do? You have to set a cursor, LCD cursor, LCD dot set cursor to column 0 and row 0. Fine. And okay, before we do anything, let's try to print whether this push button thing works. Okay, so what I will do is LCD dot print, let's say button pressed. So I don't know how it will react. So I do know I have to initiate counter and things like that, but I want to make sure whether this initial statements work. Also, this if condition. Okay, so let's upload the program. Okay, so let me press the push button. It says button pressed. Okay, so fine, we won't stop here. We will do our actual program, which we want to set up a counter. So immediately you can guess we need a count variable. So let's add a count variable, int count, say equals to 0. Let's initialize it. And now, instead of saying button press, let's add count plus plus and remove this quotes. So what it will do, it will look for digital read pin high, means the push button to be high, means button pressed, set the cursor, then print the count plus plus. So the first iteration it will print count as 0, the next time button pressed it will print count 1, and so on. So that's our actual aim, but we'll see whether it will work in that way or not. So control U to upload the program, and you can see it's done. Now I press the button. So it didn't work like we wanted. The reason is, as I'm sure most of you have guessed correctly, the button pressed is monitor but not the button release. So we have to monitor whether button released or not, otherwise you will get this numbers incremented based on the button press time. So how do we achieve that? It's very simple, although I deliberately did this to bring this topic. So let's put a while loop so that it stays here and as long as the button is pressed. So what we'll write in that while loop, we'll simply monitor our pin number 7, which is digital read P button. And for what we'll monitor, we'll monitor whether it's high or not. And we need not to write anything in the while loops, so I will terminate here. So what it will do is, let's dry run the program again. The program starts, initializes the LCD. We have this variables, p button 7, int counts 0. In fact, this variable we could easily put in setup, but doesn't matter. Coming to setup, we are initializing the LCD with 16 lines and 2 rows, 16 columns and 2 rows. We are setting the pin mode as input, p button as input, which is pin number 7. We are checking the condition where digital bit read our push button, whether it's high or not. When the button is pressed, when this button is pressed, the 5 volts appear at pin number 7, which marks this high. So moment this happen, we will set the cursor to 00, which is the first position here, first position, and lcd.print count plus plus. So what is count? Count is 0, count plus plus would be 1. It's a post increment, so First it will print 0, then it will increment to 1, likewise. And after incrementing, we are asking the program to stay until the button is high. So we are actually waiting here to be button, waiting here for button to be released. So as long as it is pressed, stay here with this while loop. So this while loop will continuously stay here and wait whether it's high or not, high or not. So moment it finds it's low, it will break this while loop and it will come out of the while loop and it will again go into this void loop program, which is an infinite while loop. So the next iteration, again it will look for high button pressed, and if it's pressed again it will come inside and increase the count. So enough talking now, so let's run the program. So I will do Control U to upload. Upload done and testing begins. So yes, 5, 6, 7, and it works. So this is a very trivial experiment. This is just a foundation for other input programs dealing with LCD. So hope you enjoyed this. We will see you in the next session. See you then.